to rush offense, why rush offense has problems. And one of the problems it starts off with is the gap. And so what we see most often is that the defending team is dictating the time. And we want to be able to flip that so that the offensive team is dictating the time. And I'll show you what I mean by that when we get into the video. Support depth. So we have one defender can check two attackers. So in other words, if you cross the blue line and all three forwards were in a straight line, that's poor support depth. You want to have people in layers. Numbers. We want to be, part of the number problem is that we're either have even numbers off the rush or worse. So when we come off the rush, we are like two against three, or we're two against four, or we're three against four. We want to have it the opposite way, either even or in the plus, where it's a three on two, or we can take a three on three and turn it into like a mini two on one. Entry point. So when you enter the offensive blue line, it doesn't change in the neutral zone. So you come up, maybe you break out the left side, and then you enter on the left side. That's a problem, especially when it's outside the dots. If you're going to exit on the outside, you need to enter in the middle or even on the right side. So the puck is changing or switching lanes. The midline, the puck is contained to one side. So after entry, the puck stays on one side, doesn't switch sides. And your shot mentality. So when all these things are bad, then what happens is we don't get any good shots. So now we start to say, well, we need to get some shots. So let's just shoot from bad angles for a rebound. And then that all of a sudden is now your best option. And that's how you know you're in really bad shape when it, as it relates to off, creating offense off the rush. Let's take a look at the principles. So first principle we want to have is speed differential. That's when the attacking team is speeding up and the defending team is slowing down. So let's take a look at this clip here, just as an illustrative. Let me grab this one. So here you can see Chicago. All the clips are of Chicago. This is Patrick Kane's line, which was the best line in the league, and they were really good off the rush. So I just pulled all the clips from them to make it easier. But you can see here as the play comes up, these guys are all slowing down, and you can see Kane is starting to speed up, and now he speeds up right there, and now he catches this guy standing still, which allows him then to take the line, and then he can go in and he finishes the play. But that's all created from a speed differential. I can show you, let's see another clip. Same idea, this time Kane comes from behind the puck. He moves the puck backwards to create speed differential. And you can see here also, this is a space speed differential where Anisimov is setting the space. So the two defenders that are up here have to watch Anisimov. He's called the stretch guy. We don't want to necessarily pass to the stretch guy so much as we want to have him setting the space. So these two D are now standing still. And now we create speed differential. So you can see these guys are flying around, and you can see this guy here is now standing still while Kane is flying. That's going to be all kinds of trouble. Now they end up entering on this side. You can see these guys here standing still, and that's how they end up creating the chance. I'll show you again. Watch this. Turn it back. Speed differential. Now they get this guy. He's standing still now. They're just constantly just flying around, creating differentials of speed, which will stacks the deck in their favor. Here's another one. Kane comes in, gets the puck in the middle of the ice. Where's the other two forwards? Oh, there they are. So what are they doing up here? Well, they're forcing the defenders to stop. That creates a runway. And this is what this is called. It's a runway for Kane. So it's open space for him to skate in. But here he goes. He's skating. He's got a speed differential, which allows him to easily take the line, push people back, and then they create a pretty good shot opportunity from the middle of the ice. How about this one? How about Kane? So again, the puck goes backwards. It moves back. These guys are all standing still. Watch Kane flying. Now he's able to get the line into the zone and generate a shot. So speed differential is a big, big deal. Here's another one. This is a D activating on this side. Now Kane comes in from underneath. See the guy standing still? That's what we want. Now no one knows what to do, and Anisimov just walks in and generates a chance. So that speed differential, it's a big deal. It was something that we want to really be able to be concentrating on, because in your league, if you're able to create any level of speed differential, you're probably going to be walking right to the net and creating some glorious scoring opportunities if that becomes your focus. Numerical advantage, mini two-on-ones or full four-on-three was better when you're crossing the red line. So we can just take a look. Any of these clips will have opportunities for that. So here, once he gets the puck here, he doesn't have an advantage, so he moves the puck back. Now when Kane enters, okay, he has a mini two-on-one right here. This is a mini two-on-one he can utilize. He also has a two-on-one here between him and there's a guy right here as well. Let me grab. See this guy? There's also a two-on-one there, or he can use this guy inside the two-on-one. But he has lots of options, and these are mini two-on-ones. It's not a two-on-one rush, but there's small two-on-ones in which he can create, and he creates a chance for his guy to be able to walk in and shoot. Changing the entry point. This is out of all the stuff, speed differential and changing the entry point are the two biggest problems in that plague most either leagues or in this case, we're talking about female hockey, which really struggles with this. And any teams that just struggle with creating rush off or creating chances off the rush, they're going to struggle with speed differential and changing the entry point. So this is moving the puck at least one lane in the neutral zone. So I'll just take this clip here. So this is a lane here inside the outside the dots where this guy is. That's a lane. Then between the dots is the second lane, and then from the dot to the boards is the third lane. So there's three lanes on the ice. What we want to do is we want to have the puck change lanes. So we can't have this guy get the puck and just keep going this way because he's going to stay in one lane. So instead of that, he moves the puck, and you can see now they've changed lanes. Now they have the puck here. Now Kane has an option in this lane, and he has an option in that lane. So then they changed lanes twice. Now they've come back to the original side, but they've changed lanes, which is key. Let's take a look at another clip. Here's another one. This is defenseman activating the rush. He moves the puck back. Now the puck's in the middle of the ice. They keep the puck in the middle of the ice. Now it's on the outside. So they change lanes, and now it's back in the middle. So they change lanes twice to create a chance. And sometimes you can pass the puck into the lane. Other times you're going to shoot. Otherwise, other times you're going to catch. Kane comes off the wall, gets the puck in the middle of the ice. He has the puck in the middle of the ice. Now he goes to the outside. What's he going to do now? Change the now it's back in the middle, creating an opportunity. So it changes lanes multiple times. The other thing, particularly with this one, is the midline. So after entry, try to ensure that the puck crosses the midline of the ice. So the midline would be from the middle goal post all the way down the ice to the other goal post. This is a one imaginary line that goes down the middle of the ice. If we watch this clip again, we can see that after entry, so Kane's going to get the puck, he changes lanes, he goes across. Now, what's he thinking about now? Well, he's got to try to find a way to change the cross the midline. See how the goalie's lined up to the puck, defenseman's lined up to the puck. There's no offense here. The offense is going to come from changing the lane and getting the goalie and everyone else to have to move. So he changes it. Now, look at this problem. Anisimov's net front, the goalie's all jammed up. But now we've got the puck into the midline of the ice. And that's a really important opportunity for us. Let's see what happens here. Change lanes. Taze changes lanes back to the middle of the ice. Now they're gonna cross the midline. There's Hossa crossing the midline of the ice. Very important play. And you can have it that way. You can also have it like a situation like this. Kane gets the puck middle of the ice. He's on the out in the middle. Now it goes to the outside. So what happens now? Look to change the midline. There it is, over to Kane. It doesn't work, but that's the idea. You can see these principles starting to play out now. Speed behind the puck. You have a runway now of opportunity. This guy has set the space. You have a speed differential. Now we change lanes. Once we change lanes, what are we looking to do now? Kane should be looking to try to generate a chance where we're going to cross the midline of the ice. Let's see the next one. Middle entry. Great pass by the D. What's he do? So now Panarin has the puck in the middle of the ice. What should he be thinking? That's right. Change, cross the midline, and shoot off the pass. Excellent. This is a good one here. Play comes out on the outside. Now, what's Kane got to be thinking about doing right now? Cross the midline. This time now they have the diamond, which we're going to get to here in a second. That's the diamond. Let me get to that, actually. So we talked about speed differential. You've seen how we use the stretch guy. You notice that when the guy takes off from the zone, we don't pass to him initially. His job is to push the D back and get them to come to kind of a slow down situation. And then when you use speed from behind the puck, get that runway. Now we see we have numerical advantages. We have to get the D in the rush all the time. That's what you'll see here. Isolations, the two-on-one entries. This is the entry points here. Importance of the dot line, manipulating the defenders by switching the side and beating the tracker. I'm going to show you some clips on that. This is what I want to get to here. This is the diamond formation. But we used to look at this as the 1-2-3 principle of attack. So what that would mean is we got three guys on the rush here. We have 1-2-3. So Kane would take the line, he'd go wide, second guy goes to the net, third guy comes high. Now what we want to do is we want to establish a diamond. So once Kane enters, you can see we have a diamond now on the entry. This guy's supposed to be driving the net. This guy is on the dot line, and now we have a D. Now all these positions are interchangeable. So the D could be this guy, and the forward could be here. The D could be this guy, and the forward could be here. The D could be this guy, and the forward could be here. It doesn't really matter as long as we have this diamond. And that allows them to create inside the diamond, and there they score on that particular play. So that's a really important piece that we got to continue to take a look at, is that diamond entry. So here the D jumping up in the play. Why is the D jumping up in the play? Because we need to create numerical advantages. So he's the best guy. Where's the forward on this play? Well, the forward was over here. The forward makes a nice pass to change the point of attack, and he gets hit. So now, if the D doesn't jump, this is a 2-on-2. Instead, the D jumps. Now it's a 3-on-2, and that allows him to gain entry. What's Kane thinking about? You guessed it. Changing the point of attack after entry and trying to cross that midline as well. So some really good situations here. Kane, middle of the ice with a runway. How does he get a runway? Because there's people ahead of him. So the first thing we have to do is get people blasting out of the zone, push the D back to create a runway where we can have speed behind the puck. Now what's he thinking? Well, he's got to get a play in which the puck is going to change sides. Here we go. Get it to change sides. Get it to go in the middle. So that's a poor example of execution. They're not all going to be good, but we got to try to find those principles and adhere to them as best we can. I'm going to show you four more clips here. Puck in the middle of the ice, not being afraid to go back, because that creates speed differential. Now Kane's flying. There's your mini 2-on-1 right there. Now they got another 2-on-1. Puck crosses the midline. There's your diamond. And now the puck comes back to the D, creates a chance. Next one, puck turns. D going to get active in the rush. Gives the puck to Kane, gets the middle of the ice. Changes the point of attack, cross the midline, creating a shot. Puck gets up the ice. Kane gets the middle of the ice. Now he goes to the outside. What's he looking to do now? You got it. Change the point of attack after entry. So here we go. After entry, get across the midline of the ice. So these are the principles we got to hold on to as best we can. All right, how's this clip? Shot block. We got three forwards. They join, cross the midline again. shot opportunity. And then we get to the loose puck. Kane's trying to change the point of attack. Good read by their D. Change. What's this play? What's he doing here? Changing the entry point. Puck was on this side. Now the entry point's on this side. This guy driving the net. Now the play changes sides, creating an opportunity, crossing the midline. That's a D in the rush there. Number five is a D. Let's watch here. Where's number five? He jumps up. Now he's in the rush. He's got created numerical advantage. One, two, three, on two. Now they cross. There's your diamond. Cross the midline again. Looking to create. Another D, active. Active D looking to be involved. Here we go. Kane gets the line. What's he looking to do? Change the point of attack. After entry, ensure that the puck crosses the midline. Kane, speed behind the puck. Where was this guy going? Watch this play. What's Panarin doing? What's his job right now? He's got to get up. Why is he getting up? He's getting up to push their D back and get them to slow down so that Kaner can come across the line with speed. There he is, speed differential. Pushes everybody back. This guy's got all the D standing still. Change the point of attack. D involved in the rush there as well. Middle of the ice. Change the lane. Change the point of attack. Cross the midline, good stick by their D, but that's exactly what they're trying to do. They're watch following their principles. Get the middle of the ice, change the point of attack, get to the midline, create a midline shot. Speed behind the puck. Kane gets a guy standing still. Because he's standing still, speed advantage. Now he get in the middle of the ice, 2-on-1 on the entry. They isolate the 2-on-1 on the entry. Now he's able to create a shot. Breakout. D, active, off the rush, jumps into the play. Kane gets the line. What's he looking to do now? Change the midline, shut off the pass, goal. That's the type of stuff that we're looking at. We have to really change your mentality here. Get away from having passing to the stretch person so the play is always going head manning the puck. Head manning the puck is over. The reason head manning the puck is difficult is because that allows the defending team to dictate the time. We got to get more support. You'll see all these rushes, they don't have three guys across the line. They have one person ahead, the puck carrier is second, another guy behind, the D is joining the rush. We have good numbers, we're changing the entry point. And we're looking to get the puck to cross the midline. These are going to be our principles. We're going to explore all of them in that hour that we have on the 24th. I can't wait to see you guys execute this stuff, especially now.